Sports. It's in the game.
Check it, reload! Check it! 220! Why is it?
Low fish. I say, Lord, be my savior when they win.
Can't win.
Check. Corner. We in this, then we gonna. Corner. Steady like my persona. Corner. Living up with honors. We used to drive them hardest. Now we pull up in the farthest. Go up. Walk in. Show up.
I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Seem like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show 'em how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show 'em how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his mans in his hand, feeling like a man. Run, put him, get the, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live without it. Red light, stop, green light, go. Everything ain't what it seem like, I know. Hold up, what you mean, where you been in? This is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? The box under the bridge, like Anthony Kiedis. Looking for something to complete us and maybe lead us. A long way from equalists, how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some,
Everybody love, everybody know. I've been knocking door down like it witness. God is my witness, I'm witness. But on the real, I think I need another witness. If it was 17, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin, certified as a house. Go figure, in my blood is the thud, venom master. It's like the devil playing spades with the pastor.
But he was born with the privilege.
Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed. Some people look ashamed when I rap, like my great-granddaddy didn't take a to the back. Not accepted by the ghetto. I don't give a fuck, praise God, I can see the light. Everybody talk about race this, race that. I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some. Everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some. Everybody love, everybody know. Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Then like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now? I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show them how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show them how to act.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's the Steelers going up against the Browns.
Thank you, Larry. From the shores of Lake Erie, EA Sports has coverage of the NFL from First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Pittsburgh Steelers and our home team. And down he goes just shy of the 25. Now a penalty marker is down. Let's see what that's about. What you call a hit stick. Put down to the ground hard, right at the line of scrimmage. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
Kizer to throw it. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 21-yard line.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Let's go!
Kizer on third and two. Eluding the pressure right. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. Only able to get back a yard for his efforts, and that leads us to fourth down.
And, partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
Back at the 20. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. They'll go again with Bell. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. It'll be a gain of five, and it's going to bring up a third and about seven left.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
7 yards remain now on third down. Gun, Dobbs. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And this punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40. And now the Browns coming out on the field. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
First and 10, Kizer. He sets to fire deep. The swing pass caught. A big play that time for Cleveland. 62 yards.
Well, he took a shot downfield towards the end zone, and he came up with a big-time catch, but he was tackled a little bit short of the goal line. Now the defensive guys, they got to pick their heads up and try and hold them to a field goal attempt.
And he is not going to get through here on try number one. They stop him at the goal line. Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal. Running back, and he's gonna go backward. They get him behind the line. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. And again, this time to the tailback, and he takes this one in for a Brown score. A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season, and the Browns have taken the early lead. It's up and through to make it 7-0 Browns. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And now out come the Steelers. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So the D-line's going to spread out. Now a first down carry by Bell. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Kind of running there at your own risk against that 4-3 in that big line, aren't you?
Yeah, and I don't really run it against a good 4-3 team that well because I've got to get those guys on the move a little bit. If you're a static running team, meaning you just want to run it in the middle, you may have some trouble against good defensive tackles. That's what we just saw on that play. No gain.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to lead to a third and 11.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Throwing here, Dobbs going up top. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
Yeah, and they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. And the Browns getting set to go. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Kaiser. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's caught inside the 30. It's a big play there for the Browns. 52 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Well, he's been the guy already over 100 yards here in the first half. Could have had a lot more if he would have been able to haul that one in.
Yeah, in fact, our statistician Marvin was already handing me a piece of paper with that yardage totaled on it. He thought that catch was going to happen just as you and I did as well.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field, and really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. To the air again, Kaiser. And got his man complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well-organized, well-coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Guts fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store.
Here we go. Ohio. Flex round. Flex round.
They'll give this to Bell running right. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. From the shotgun, here's Dobbs. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
After the penalty, it's Bell. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Slot man moves right. Cut. On second down, Dobbs. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Halfback sent in motion. Dobbs is throwing. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Sheldon Richardson. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down. And he's been a busy man here this first half as he gets it away. This is taken at the 18. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Browns will take over first and 10. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
You know, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them, every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They got to feel pretty good about that one.
And now here's a carry heading left. And he is going to lose yardage here. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. The Browns on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7.
Here we go! Ohio!
To throw, Kizer. And he's going to be out of bounds up around the 45-yard line. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe-tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
Kizer. Complete. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. A big play that time through the air. 42 yards. Kizer now to throw on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Throwing again is Kizer on 2nd and 10. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Gonzalez now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And the Steelers set to take the field. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3 and out here or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. The Steelers on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 11. Here's Dobbs to throw. And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Danny Shelton able to get him down behind the line of scrimmage, and it'll be fourth down. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give him a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total.
Come on, let's go! Ohio! Ohio!
A first down throw for Kaiser. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first. First down. He's going to fire one deep over the... And this is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. And that one results in 35 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
So if I'm an offensive coordinator, there's one thing that I know for sure. This is one of the top five teams in the NFL against the run. So when I look at my playlist, I'm probably thinking about throwing it.
Now a handoff here to his running back. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. They've been stuffed twice here for losses. Now it's third and goal. From the shotgun, it's Kaiser. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Typically down in the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive, but they're down to the point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience.
Yeah.
You know, take your time. First half, you still got a chance. I think they're out of patience here. This has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it.
Dobbs looking to throw on first down. Going deep here for Bryant. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them, they've sat back.
I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Here we go. Grand 38. Ohio. Ohio. Flex route. Flex route.
Dobbs now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
He completes it to Bryant, and he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
Here we go.
And the wideout in motion. On first down, Dobbs to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 12. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
He's going to look deep down the field. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
Let's go!
Play of the half, Kizer. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove. And what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. Tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
That's fielded in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things.
And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
And some changes Ohio, here as the D-line Ohio, separates
go.
Some.
Flex round! Flex round! Come on, let's go! White 90!
The give is to Bell. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Here we go!
Again, it's Bell. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up.
Well, it hasn't been a whole lot of fun for Le'Veon Bell in this ball game, trying to find room to run the ball. I'm sure they're going to have to change some things up because he's so versatile. They've got to get the ball in his hand somehow and create some space because they're losing this game.
Well, and defensively, you've got to key in on Bell, make him the focal point to stop him, and they've been able to do that.
And he's gotten better every year he's been in the league.
And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off near the 34, and they'll have the ball set up in the red zone at the 16-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find the spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Following the interception, Kaiser. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. T.J. Watt coming in from that outside linebacker spot to bury him for a loss of 7.
Here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
The Browns on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and 17.
Here we go.
Working out of the gun. Here's Kaiser. Pressure comes, and the Steelers take him down. Ryan Shazier in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for 6, but they do get 3.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
You think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 36. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick 6 last week. Not a pick 6 here, but an interception.
Hey, it's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week, he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
Only a yard that time, 2nd and goal.
The way things have gone in this one, the running game's been something of an afterthought, and that's not been too bad for them, has it?
Yeah, the offensive returns have been good, but I guess we figured he and the ground game would be a bit more involved. Second down throw for Kaiser. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down. The offense on 3rd down, they've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. They're looking at a 3rd and goal here. Time running out here on the play clock. Kizer, third and goal. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Browns take advantage of field position on a turnover to cash this one in. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Steelers offense gets ready to get back onto the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
On second down, it's Bell. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. In motion right is Bryant. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And now running right through it. Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first and 10, Dobbs. And that's complete to Jesse James. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. On the counter, here's Bell. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 10 more there and another first down.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage just comes through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down.
Yeah, he's going to lose yardage here as they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. They'll try the right side with Bell. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down at the 11-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be third down. Now Dobbs. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the 5. It's a gain of 6 as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Now Bell. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
What a game this defense has played. They're pitching a shutout, so it'd be fun to watch down the stretch to see if their defensive coordinator continues to be as aggressive as he's been all game long. Ohio!
Ohio! They come out here in the eye. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the 1. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory. Another stop on third down, and this defense still hasn't allowed a touchdown to this point.
A field goal does you no good, so they're going to stay out there and go for it on fourth. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll run it with Bell. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Le'Veon Bell, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Steelers are able to at least knock the deficit down a bit. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. Now here's Succop out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Browns offense trotting back onto the field. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we've reached the point in the broadcast where you and I, we may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that, because we got to try and keep people around. We don't want them to change the channel. Stay with us in this game. Is that Ben Ramsauer? Are you hearing from Ben on the headset here? Tell us.
Stretch
this thing out a little bit.
Get some talking points. Dig them all out.
That's what you get. A big-time producer. Keep them here.
Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Where Brandon Pace comes into play now, because they've got the advantage, they've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is, don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on. Third down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Third down, Kaiser. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation. The Browns send out their punter now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent. But you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
So the offense has it first and 10.
Ohio, let's go. White, nine, flex round.
A give to Bell. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Here we go. Grand 38. Grand hot.
Now they'll try to sweep with Bell. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. So that is now 2 fumble return touchdowns. You talk about something that's going to drive a head coach crazy.
Without a doubt. But for the defensive guys, once you do it once, you create a frenzy. Everybody wants to get involved, and they got it done a second time.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd and 11. To throw is Dobbs. Caught right side, Davis. It'll be a gain of 17 at a Pittsburgh first. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Come on, let's go! White 90! White 90!
Dobbs. A screen to Bell. Room to run past midfield. And he is knocked down from the side. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this.
Here we go.
Here's Dobbs to throw. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. 11 more on that one and another first down. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Out of the pistol, it's Bell. Even with him busting through the contact, he'll still be stopped just inside the 35. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people.
And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 21. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right? And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they meant.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. And he'll bring this all the way up to the 45-yard line. Now they get a 4th-quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Goes underneath for Bell. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll bring up a 2nd down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And no escaping. moving this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds remaining in the football game. Throwing here, Dobbs. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. They convert on third with a gain of 22.
Here we come.
Out of the gun, Dobbs. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. On second down, Dobbs. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Sheldon Richardson in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. And the back goes into motion. From the shotgun, here's Dobbs. Over the middle, complete. It's James. And he'll go down at the 28. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off inside the five. And that will write a finish to this ball game. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all.